Hi everyone. Today I am in the mood to draw something, and yesterday I've taken a break, and as you know, I always say make sure you try to draw or paint something every day so that you don't get out of it. And so I just did this hydrangea painting or drawing with the pencil. I used just a B pencil that I told you I sharpened with a knife, and in this part of the drawing I used it like that. So you just basically, instead of drawing with the point, you draw with the side of it, giving it a softer edge. And over here I then switched to the point again because I wanted some more precision, and there were some flowers overlapping, and when I'm going to go over with watercolor, it will be quite confusing. Like here, three flowers are actually overlapping, so some of the petals going on top of this flower then comes out on top of this flower, that flower comes on top, so it becomes a little bit, it can become a bit confusing. So one thing I wanted to mention before I go ahead and do the watercolors, which I will also film, is that basically I looked at these flowers here. My son picked them a few days ago for me, and I really wanted to make sure I paint them. They're quite pretty, and I looked at the composition and I picked the flowers that I liked. You can see, I think, is it the three flowers? Yes, yeah, so these three flowers from this point is the ones that are overlapping, and I put them here, and there are a few flowers on top over here, which I also picked. You can see this petal is right here. So I basically picked a shape that I liked, and then just added a few bits and pieces. So this one is predominantly something similar is there, but not exactly like that. And also here I added a flower. There isn't a flower that looks exactly like that, but the idea is that when you look at the flower, just try to think ahead of the composition that you want to achieve. And the way I'm drawing these face girls or the flower girls is that I need to know what's going to happen. So in this case, this isn't going to be the body or the skirt, the dress of the girl. This is going to be a headpiece, so I'm going to go ahead and draw the face. So I wanted a certain shape of the flowers to cover her head, and hence why without these flowers you can see something is missing. Sorry, I cut off there. I think without this flower, you need something there which kind of completes the shape of this. So it's perfectly fine to do that because you already learned the shape of the petals, how they curl, what they look like, and you can completely abandon the actual flower composition and just go ahead and add a few bits and pieces just to balance it out. So I'm going to zoom it in just again, just for you to have a look once more. Detailing, I just did quite basic because you can see on the flower the detailing is trying to find, where's the pencil here, it's like a star shape with some bits and pieces, which I will go ahead and just probably use a black pen just to add some detail over there. So let's go ahead and draw the face and then go into watercolors as well. Okay, so I pulled out my watercolors here, and I decided instead of drawing the face, the way I usually do these girls is by completing the flower first, because that gives me an idea of what colors I want to go for the face and how I want to finish it. So I always do the flower first and then draw on the details. So in terms of pink, so these are my Daniel Smith. I'm going to use alizarin crimson, probably quinacridone magenta, quinacridone violet, quinacridone pink, and opera pink. So five pinks basically, reds/pinks that I might be using to mix some colors up. So the actual color of the flower is this pink, but I'm not necessarily going to go, this isn't a botanical painting, so I'm not going to try and do exactly that. So what I will concentrate on is the shading and the depth of color. As you can see, towards the center is darker and paler towards the edges, and where petals are overlapping, you get a shade over there as well. So that's predominantly what I will concentrate on. So let me just do the first flower and see how I get on. I will probably so I'm just going to see what I can mix over here. I'm going to go with, let's see, quinacridone violet and just use my board right here, and maybe a little bit of opera pink just to brighten it up. Let's have a look. Yeah, that looks quite nice. So I am going to take this flower here and just start by adding a darkest color where I can see it, and I'm going to do petal by petal. So I went and got some water and I'm going to basically add it like that and let the water flow and do the job. Now I'm going to go back in, and because I went with the wet brush, it's not going to be as bright now. It will dilute a little bit more, which is okay because I don't want exact color throughout. I want some texture and I want some color play and flow. So there we go. I think well, for me personally, for my taste, I like to leave some red. It's quite important. Some white of the paper, not red. I'm going to go ahead, because I like that color quite a lot, I'm going to go ahead and mix just a bit more of it. Actually, before I mix it, I'm just going to use quinacridone violet on its own, just again to give it some interest and just to break it up. You can see how I am now breaking up the petal coloring. Doesn't have to be exactly the same, and it starts to look a little bit more interesting. So I'm just going to do that. Also, at this point, I'm kind of glancing over to the real flower, but I'm not following everything as it is. So sometimes you get too much water, you can dry your brush. I basically use my tissue over there, go into this area, and it's still damp. While it's damp, you can go back into the color, pick the color up, and then just drop it, just to create that depth. And you see, because it's watercolor, how beautifully it starts to flow. So, and then on top of that, with clean water, I then can go in and create these beautiful flowing effects. So let me do the last petal. I'm going to go into opera pink. And this time I'm going to get more opera pink than I did last time. Then I'm going to go into here. It's because I want a bit more color here. And then, sorry if I'm cutting off, it's really hard to hold the phone with one hand and look at the picture outside of the screen. So I think I'm quite satisfied here. So I'm going to go in and let the watercolor do its job like that. I think I'm really happy with how this has gone. You can control it a little bit, like you see. If you want a touch more color here, you can just make it move a little bit like that. But it's beautiful. Also, I would make sure I would use exactly the same color somewhere else as a repetition, just to have some balanced looking flower. So I think there is one more petal here. Let's go ahead and finish that. I'm going to go get more quinacridone violet, and keeping in mind that it's behind the other petals, it's going to be the darkest. So let's do that. And then we're going to let the color flow and do its job. So the other thing to think about is that it's sometimes quite beautiful if it flows into the neighboring color, and it just looks very pretty to me. And also, as they call it, the water control, you have to make sure you don't put too much water, otherwise it will start puddle up and it won't create the effect that you want. Okay, so that's one flower done. Let me go ahead and do some more, and we'll catch up then. I have now finished doing the watercolor, and this is what it looks like. So as you can see, I have broken down the colors. I have used all five that I mentioned before, and I have mixed some of the opera pink in this petal, and these two, just to make it pop a little bit. And also, you can see there is a bit more red in here and there. That also creates interest, although I'm not happy with this particular petal. It looks a little bit flat to me at the moment, because I tried to correct it. It was a little bit too red and it was standing out too much compared to a lot of the pink. So here's the opera pink and there as well. Yeah, so I had to correct it, and unfortunately it now looks flat because of that. It really is a bad idea to sometimes go back in with this particular watercolor technique. And some of the petals are left quite pale, some of them are brighter and deeper. So I think that creates a nice kind of effect. And yeah, so that's the composition. I am going to go ahead and draw the face now, and then later on I will also do the centers of the flowers as well once the watercolor has dried properly. So let's go ahead and do that. So I now have added some details, and I have outlined the hydrangea petals just to give them a little bit more of a popping effect. And I left the centers of the flowers white with just the pen, and I'm okay with it. I like that look. I have drawn the face and it looked quite simple, and because there were gaps between the flowers, it actually looked like she was bald. So I decided to go ahead and do some line work to create sort of like a, I don't know, like one of those, you know, tight swimming hats kind of thing. It's not, but something like that, just to give give the a more kind of put together look of the hat, and just, you know, I didn't want to have any hair because the flowers should speak for themselves. And so that's what it looks like, and I'm going to go ahead and finish the face. So I have finished now with the face. I used the quinacridone magenta for the lips. So it's quite dark because it's hardly any water there. The same watercolor I used for the cheek, and I then dabbed it off with a tissue because I didn't want it to be too much. As you can see, there's lots of petals going on there. And that is it. And what else? For the eyes, I mixed I think a variety of color actually. I mixed some moon glow with, I think, Enanthrone blue to create a sort of gray color. And for the eyeshadow that you can see, I just used water, and the pen that I did the drawing with is the Pilot G-Tech C4 that I keep saying is the only pen I use for my drawings. It's water soluble, so once you add water, you can actually pull it out slightly and create that look. So let me just zoom in so you can have a look at the flowers again and the face. I do prefer the flowers than the face in this instance. I feel the face being on a bigger scale than I usually draw. I find it doesn't have that sort of character that I like it to have. But I do like the way it came out. I think it's quite balanced in my opinion. And yeah, so that was fun to do. And you know, try to do it yourself. One thing I'd say as well is that I find hydrangea quite challenging, maybe is the word, because it's just, it has so many petals, and it just, when you look at it, it just is, you know, there's so much going on, so many flowers overlapping, and it can be overwhelming to just take a pencil and start drawing it. But I think, you know, for days and days I was trying to do that, and I'm happy I sat down and had a look, and it's not actually as complicated as it first looks. If you're just patient and have a good look, concentrate on the flowers, you will be able to understand the structure, and then, like I said, just guide it yourself to where you want which flower to go to create a certain shape. And that is it. So thanks for watching, and see you soon.